Hello. If you're in those Dutch mafias that I'm profiling, this is episode 8. I'm going to give you an opportunity, yeah, like the De Lamonts and the FDR family. Yeah, this is your opportunity to relent.
Would you like to make your confession?
Your Eminence, I'm it's been so long.
I'll just take this opportunity to show you some of the sins that have been committed in the American nation in recent years by the Dutch Mafia.
I've used up too much of your time.
I always died to save souls.
Well, I'm beyond redemption.
Potete andare via per 2-3 minuti per favore. Grazie.
I hear the confessions of my own priests here. Sometimes the desire to confess is overwhelming, and we must seize the moment.
What is the point of confessing if I don't repent?
I hear you are a practical man. What have you got to lose?
Hesses all. Pi Pi Piso Pillsbury Doughboy. Dough in his bags. The current fraudster. Freemason. And potentially the light of the world.
Your sins are terrible, and it is just that you suffer.
And the blight of
your life will be redeemed. But I know that you don't believe that. You will not change. There you go, dear soul, in the name of the Father, in the Spirit of Santos. Amen.
So, that's my mate Al. You can call me Betty if you call me Al. Yeah, all of it is the joke about the world being taken from the world's people. Yeah, and in that Godfather movie, episode 1, which I watched last night, which is why I want everybody to get the chance to save their souls, I learned that in the five mafia families, when the families start feuding together, when they try and assassinate Godfather number one, who's played by Marlon Brando, the cover for Brandeis in World War One, yeah, they introduce the five mafia families in New York, and one of them is the Tartaglias. Let me show you what they look like in the Tartaglia mafias in New York. Very menacing, yeah, they blow each other auto bits, yeah, and Sonny gets executed near the Reedsdale region of New York with the statue of the Empire State joke for Britain hanging over the top of all of their heads. This is, it's actually told me that I've searched for the wrong thing. It's Tartaglio in that joke, in English, in Britain, for the bishopric. Yeah? But here, the Tartaglios, it's either that one there, the sleazy looking one with the British American tobacco in his hand, or it's that seedy looking one there with the very Italianesque profile. Okay, there he is again, looking a little bit wizened. One of them is a Tartaglio. Let me introduce you to Glasgow's mafias, led by this man, and the Glasgow mayor had to come out as a homosexual when I started my research on the Glasgow mafias. That includes Michael Moore's assassination bureau, run under the name of Crawl, right next door to the Clutha pub, where the helicopter came crashing through the roof. Okay, so this is called Inside the Synod, with Glasgow Mafias, Philip Tartaglio at the head of the Godfather families. Yeah, really, really violent. This one looks like one of the hitmen. He's quite a plump person. That may be politically incorrect and very dangerous for me to declare.
There's been a very strong tone of pastoral concern for people in difficult situations. Of course, it's not just about exceptions. We've got to also encourage people, normal Catholic parents and families who are living family life with its joys and struggles. So that needs to be endorsed big time, and as well as looking at the difficult situations of de facto union.
So do you get it? Looks as if he's had his nose smashed in. That might have been the Corleone family. Yeah, they hit people on the heads in that movie with dustbin lids, and that's the dustbin story that you've just looked at on the Hillary Clinton Wombles Pillsbury tab. Yeah, all of it, all of the violence in all the countries around the world, that's Vietnam, Korea, all of Nixon's sins, yeah, are covered up, and all of them, yeah, become the album covers for the Rolling Stones for the non-existent fucking Jesus. Okay? And it's ever so easy to see through it. Yeah, and all of the Godfather movie is ever so spooky. Everybody's disloyal to everybody else. Everybody gets shot down and gunned down. And that is the joke that I've just shown you in that movie clip. Okay, so do you get the magnitude of it? So let's just transit slowly back to the Dutch solutions. Yeah, and I've just picked this one because this is the Dick Van Dyke film. Yeah, you get the Dick Van Dyke Van Din Mafia Dynasty jokes, and this is how, as a Catholic now, I need to heal my sins because I've not got the courage to go to confession. None of the other religions, you need to go to confession to have your soul saved now. It's a master plan by the mafias.
With TV's investment tool, my choices are clear. Find your next investment today.
In every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap! The job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake.
Delightful way.
Tom Hagen, the consigliere Kagan for George Bush. Do you get it? Enough. Yeah. So, a call to confession. Yeah, it's amazing. That's the Catholic way of finding out everybody's coercibility. Yeah, and because the priest has to be celibate, the whole of the good bloodlines disappear over time. It's a master plan. Arrius Calpurnius Piso, the cleverest man that ever lived, the likeliest man who ever walked this earth to be the devil. And that was written into the Bible by his own son. Here are the sins of the nymphomaniacs that are the lookalikes for Hans Rosling, that is just the cover for the man on the rich list that is called Rousing. And I believe he's pictured below. He looks a little bit like Ian PIESLEY, the scientific, the sectarian specialist in Divided Ireland. I think that's him. That's not Ian PIESLEY, that's Hans Rosling. And Hans Rosling is my mate that is the statistician. Okay, this is where we got to yesterday, and the launch of the sweeties, and I need to go to confession, because every time I arrive late at the Church of Scotland, there is no one guarding their candy collection at the bottom of the stairs, and I'm so late sometimes that I just sit there and I feel compelled to sin all of the time. Yeah, these are the threats to depopulate the world by launching the obesity epidemic, which is the reason why I fell out with Lord Sainsbury when I was in New Zealand. And Lord Sainsbury at that time was the science minister. Yeah, and the British, he's the richest former politician in our country. It's really, really fascinating. Yeah, so we're on to the Dutch Mafias again. Yeah, and that was a very... Yeah, if you look at the Godfather movies and you watch the parties for all of the Catholics that are in the Godfather lineages out of Italy, they are often pictured wearing they're often pictured wearing rose coloured or orange coloured garments, as Sonny takes one of the rather plump women upstairs and shags her behind the door. Yet before he gets summoned to Marlon Brando's conciliario so they can make the decisions about whether or not they kill the people that are attending those wedding things. And that is the way that the whole of America has been run since Jesse James took over the mafias and the central banks. Yeah, there were 6,000 places where they issued their currency from when America was still free to do things locally and before the Fed was taken over by the Rothschild family. There's Bill Gates, the richest of all. Without his inventions that are computers and translation tools, the world would still be enslaved. So do you get it? Let's now move down and see what we've yet to disclose. So this is the Dutch Mafias again. Here's the Van Duyne Candies. Van Duyne Candies has its kitchen and administration at 739 Northeast Broadway, Portland, or they operate 10 retail candy stores in Portland, one in Silverdale, Washington, near Bremerton. Yeah? Okay. You remember all the Germans that were in league with the rocket scientists and the nuclear specialists in Göttingen and Heidelberg University, all of them end up in Germany very soon, many of them before the war starts, and that's the Al Jolson story out of Russia. Yeah, all of them are the elite families that run the world and the whole of those other countries in Europe before Christianity was invented and taken out there in 1640, I think, or 1620, by the PI PI Pilgrim Fathers. So did you understand that image that you just saw with the pictures of the PI PI Pillsbury Doughboys? Yeah, it's all the same fucking PI PI joke right through. Okay, the Otto Pisos, that's the Ottoman Empire launched by the Piso family, which launched false Christianity. And the Dum Dum jokes, we've already seen that one. That's the jokes about the bullets that explode your head, and that was really useful for the mafia families. Yeah, where one of the most dangerous are the Tartaglios, the family that is the Godfather family. They had to conciliate and make a treaty with those other five ruthless families, and Tartaglio is now the Archbishop in Scotland, and his cardinal is, I attended the celebration. The cardinal is a guy called Leo Cushley, which is the Piso piss take about the naming of the Nile as the Cush, yeah, or the Pishon, and every joke that they share is taken into the great conflicts as they pick the Pope to be the genocidal partner of the fascist armies and to launder all of the fascist culprits, yeah, on both sides, out of the country and into Latin America, where the current Pope comes from. And he helped with the genocides in the 1960s and gave confession to the leaders. That's the dad of Queen Maxima in the Netherlands. Right then, let's get a move on. Yeah, and a spoonful of sugar might make it okay for you, Maria, as you prance down the mountainside, but that's one of the biggest jokes of all. So that's the Bremer Mafia family, and Bremerhaven is the place where they launch the Austrian Navy. Austria is totally landlocked. And somewhere in Mary Poppins' lifetime, she might have done something good, but I very much doubt it. I don't know how those people that make those massive jokes about the world's biggest religion and the Virgin being the Maria joke, yeah, they make all of those movies. And the Mary Poppins thing is about the launch of the banking frauds into England in the 1960s under the bowler hat, with all of the sad bastards smoking the Piso pipes, like Harold Wilson as he carpet bombed the Garden of Eden. Yeah? Climb every fucking mountain and the Detweiler manufacturers of the drones are the Detweiler Swiss family singers. Right then, so, and there's a lovely lookalike for Mary Poppins in St John's, the Church of Scotland. And I always confess to them that I steal their sweeties when nobody's looking. But you don't need to do that. You don't need to do that in the Protestant religions, and that's why they wear so many orange garments. Yet the woman who rejects Godfather 3, played by Al Pacino, is called Kay, and she's lovely. She's just a beautiful, graceful little woman. She gets deserted by him when he goes off and marries somebody in Sicily, who gets blown to bits too. Yeah, and that's where the Godfather jokes were launched. Most of the crimes are actually in the south of France. Yeah, and the whole of world history is twisted. Okay, so there's the Baltic coast, there is Bremerhaven and the launch of the Austrian fucking navy fighting for Kaiser Bill, who's the head of the British Navy when World War I starts. Yeah, and that's Kaiser Bill's relatives and the Bismarcks and all of Hitler's people. And remember that Hitler is also the Rothschilds Mafias. That's Hitler, and his dad was Alois. Yeah, and all of that is documented by my mate Greg Hallett. The 63-year-old company is... Okay, Comics Central, Red Tag Shopping Company. I'm not sure what this is. This is Google Images, search for... Oh, this is the Bremer Company. So this is Red Tag Shopping, Comics Central. And I'm not sure whether it is the... I'm not sure how that, what that image relates to. So just ignore it for the moment. If it comes back to me further down, I will relate to you. Oh, this is the launch of the sinister launch of the Marvel Comics stories. So this is Comics Central, and then you find in the next search that Comics Central is Marvel. Yeah, that is all the Superman jokes. That's the Superman that died when he fell off his piezo fucking horse and broke his neck. And it's Klaus Maswich in World War One, yeah, as the person who censors all of the mail from the trenches. That's the "I'm dead and I've shit my underpants, can you please send me more" jokes from the British government and the Durham Light Infantry Museum. And Klaus Maswich ran all of the jokes about Andy Pandy, Teddy Roosevelt coming to help, and Andy Pandy wears the death camp uniforms, yeah, that all the Jews died in. And the Klaus Maswich, can you guess what religion he is? Because he launches Dr. Finlay and all the Zionist jokes about eating pork too late and getting pathology from it. Dr. Cameron, yeah, Lochiel of Cameron, all of them are in the same joke. That's Camerinus in the Roman court. It's absolutely ruthless. And they ask the poor people to confess to their sins, yet so that they can become local councillors and get coerced. Now you can touch Lola all you want with the new Coulson. There's the same Marvel cover-ups. That's Disney, the comics. They are the richest Zionist institution on the globe now, Walt Disney. And all of the stories that they make, yeah, are jokes about popular culture. The three bears are the Bayer Rothschild family. Yeah, everything is a joke about world history and financial services. Okay? So, and Coulson is the man that was picked to be Rebecca Brooks and Rupert Murdoch's expert in Intel. Yeah, he's the phone hacking specialist. He becomes the lover of Rebecca Brooks when they're backed into the corner by me. And Rebecca Brooks is never divorced. I'd love for her to become a free woman. Yeah, but the rate at which she is aging now, because of that Dorian Gray phenomenon, yeah, she may not become eligible for very much longer unless she gets back on side on behalf of all of the brutalised world and all of the taxpayers that she steals from, relentlessly in league with General Sir Mike Jackson and the Balkans mafia leaders that committed a massive genocide so that we could own all of the houses in that region and teach them how to play cricket. Here's the Van Dins and all of the Marvel jokes. Yet when God catches up with them, yet this is the Ant-Man launch. All of the cover-ups, now that I'm onto everything that happens, they are launching dozens of new bands, dozens, hundreds of new celebrities, and everything that you look for, if you wait for 3 or 4 days, it's a cover-up by something totally trivial. And they regret many of those movements, because when they put the mosque into EastEnders, yeah, I'm onto it right away. And here's Emma Sale runs Killing Kittens, where Commoner Kate is the prostitute, and this is Miss Sailor's Candies. Okay, 16 shopping mall releases and wholesale candy to other candy distributors. It also operates a subsidiary called Miss Sailor's. Yeah, do you get it? That's the madam in Killing Kittens is Miss Sale, Emma Sale. Yeah, a rowing fellow of, and my wife was also embroiled in the rowing scams. Yeah, even although she was at the lowly Otago Polytechnic, and when they went for the regatta, it was a windy day, and guess which of the corrupted New Zealand teams it sank in the middle of the lake? Yeah, the Inland Revenue team. None of the tax for the country. Yeah. Even in New Zealand, where they're ever so spirited and ever so fightable, yet on the rugby pitch, and ever so great on the rugby pitch, their democracy is totally mined out by the British Empire. Yet everything there belongs to HRH. Yeah, and that's the launch of HRH's daughter-in-law, yeah, and her madam. Okay, there she is as the rowing expert. Yeah, it was hugely stressful for me to see my lovely wife in the Otago Polytechnic team and not to know whether or not her boat had sunk. Yeah, Mark Carter, the man who was the head of that big four auditing company and all of the Queen's massive companies and all of the military companies, was in the team. Yeah, the Inland Revenue team must have been really, really really, really abusing God's laws. Okay. And there's Kate. Hello. There she is with the madam, Miss Sale. Okay. So, we get Getty images further down. What are they? Birthing gear in the Lindo wing. Oh yeah, there she is. There's her with her underwear on. And that could have been useful in Killing Kittens. And Greg Halleck claims that that picture was not taken in the Lindo wing where she had the children. It was actually taken on the catwalk in Killing Kittens as she was pimping for business. And that's George, and that's kind of offensive to me now. Right then. So, we've lost track of the Dutch connection. Yeah, this is Long Beach, California. Van Din has in turn been bought out by Van Ryan. Oh. Yeah, that takes us onto the beaches in Normandy, and all of it is really quite sick. Not sure why we've... Oh, they've not allowed me to scan down using that. Oh, here we go. Now, this woman is a dead ringer for a woman called Marge in the movie made by the Cohen brothers. That's the High Priests of Israel joke. That's the Ali G Baron Cohen, and Professor Cohen, Baron Cohen, of autism. You remember the autism scams and the MMR injection scandal? Yeah? All of the injectable stuff the media portray as a massive menace, but God looks after the good people. Yet there are not many of those to look after now. Thank you to those of you who have come forward. It's been a magnificent weekend, because I realise that there are good people and loyalist people in Scotland after all. And they are also in the legendary rowing teams about the people that saved the revolutionaries from Freemasonic France. Bonnie Prince Charlie, the effete icon for Scottish freedom. Right then. So, Marge in Hollywood, Cohen Brothers, High Priests of Israel. That's where the law enforcement jokes are reinforced, and all of the members of that cast is a joke also about the Air Force One films, and all of it, there's Saving Private Ryan and all the bits of the bellies hanging out on the beach. He's linked to the Nixons and the Nixon bloodlines, yeah, and he is the head actor. Tom Hanks is a Rockefeller. In 1990, American Confectionery Inc. of Chino, California, Calvary Hill, was listed as owner of Van Duyne Candies. Oh, we're moving quite quickly. Okay, yeah, that's the Normandy Beach. I could not tolerate to watch that movie, but now that I understand all of their massive genocides, it's an obligation for me, and I'm quite comfy with it now. In 1990, American Confectionery launched Chino, California, was owner of Van Duyne Candies, and that is the Vietnam War. Yeah, all of that has all occurred now. I'm not sure why we've jumped to Vietnam. Indochina covers since FDR accused Stalin of totalitarianism. So do you get it? That's Indochina and all of the press cover-ups. That's the Bin Lorry, Bin Laden covers. It's the same method, yeah, as the Pillsbury Piso Doughboys and the launch of the Wombles and Jimmy Savile Beyond the Grave and all of the stories about him being a villain. And none of that was interrupted when he was being a villain and shagging the little kids with Prince Philip. And that is why Prince Philip is the veteran that is in charge of the Dunblane School as its patron. And he appoints all of the Knights of Malta. And maybe that has something to do with Lady Jane Grosvenor's plight too, because all of them cannot own themselves and cannot behave decently even in their own marriages, Mrs Valerie Jane Lees. Okay, so do you get it? The reason I'm highlighting Vietnam War, launched by Johnson, Nixon, and all of those people that put Kennedy in the grave, because he had the greatness to take America out of that. Yet, because of the Freemasonic activities that mean that even Danton in the French Revolution becomes a Freemason in America after the French Revolution has killed 600,000 poor people for the Rothschilds, funding all sides and getting them the central bank in London, yeah, because of the Waterloo victory, yeah, it is massive, okay, and everything is trivialised. Okay, and so Stalin, immediately after the war's over, they need another divisive policy, and that becomes the accusation that Stalin's a bad man in the profiteering team. He was trained in London, in Sydney Street, yeah, and he's accused by FDR, who is an ancestor of the Pilgrim Father Mafias from Holland and the Leiden Coast. Near Bremerhaven. Right then. So, here we've got American Confectionery and the Van Dins and the Chino Express vents for it. And there's the Smarties, which have become the M&Ms, the Mariam joke for the Aryan master race that were the illegitimate parents of the Roman Emperor's children. That's Caligula's shagging of Mariam, yeah, to make it look as if she is the mother and the father at the same time. I can't remember exactly what the Piso joke is, but her child, yeah, that's Poppea, was shagged by Caligula, and they sired together the bastard child that is Arrius Calpurnius Piso. And that's the accusation. Yeah, they twist everything in the Bible to make anti-Arianism an obligation, and then they make the Virgin Mary the mother of the gods in the heavens, and that makes them ever so angry. Yeah. Right then, these statistics were the ones I was able to get. They may be outdated. Okay, that's not highlighted, so let's keep going down. There was an Illuminati plan, poisoned candy to American school children. Okay, and there's the obesity consequences of everything that Lord Sainsbury did when he was the fucking science minister in Britain. Yeah, there were type 2 diabetes all over Glasgow, where Philip Tartaglio is saving all of those fat kids' souls out of the mafia families in New York. I'm coming against the tide of the Pilgrim Fathers jokes of the YMCA, and the Rangers get the butt of that because they become the we are the village people, yeah, in the joke for David Murray, who in the end is the butt of God's joke because he loses both of his legs for what he's done, yeah, in the sectarian sector. And in all of that stuff, about 66 people being killed in the Ibrox disasters. No one can know whether any of those things are true, because the police that are portrayed in the American movies, yet in the Godfather film, the policeman beats the third Godfather and breaks his jaw in a fist. You know, he's being detained and they want him locked up, yet because he's in league with one of the families. I don't think it was the Tartaglios of Glesky and the Catholic, yeah, the Catholic crime scene. Okay, so that's Lord Sainsbury leading the lethal obesity epidemic, and the median age and life expectancy because of that has now comes downwards from our being fit and, you know, totally competent and totally funded as a country. In the 1970s, that's when the Rothschilds started selling off the national assets. Hannah, still waiting for your phone call. Okay, so what are we on to now? This is the type 2 diabetes, yeah, and that's where you have to take drugs to suppress, to promote the insulin release, because the body cannot cope with it physiologically. It's tragic. Okay, I contacted a Van Dyne representative about any company plans to distribute candy to schools, but got no information. Richard McCall, who was the president, borrowed 391,000 of the company's funds for his personal use. Okay, and what the next one is McCall of Monaco, J.P. Morgan, George Soros and Michael Moore. This is the same families that are the J.P. Morgans that fund Tony Blair for all of his private initiatives, unelected initiatives. He gets £10,000 for lecture hour, per lecture hour, from all of the massive fascist institutions that he visits. That's the World Trade Center, run by the Royal Princess Fergie, who does the toe-sucking, because that is the Piso jokes about the vagina and the feet, and the Jesus joke about kissing the feet. And Mammy Kenneth Kalman is the one that arrests and allows the spies to be flee into communist Russia. And the whole of it is a sad, sad saga, and all of the news is coming out unless they kill me really quickly. This theft of company funds was forgiven when he gave up his position and his share of stock so that he was no longer had control over a large block of the stock. This is hedge fund management. It's total theft. And Alex Salmond does it, John Key does it, all of the world leaders are banking magnates, and most of them are from the elite families that run the world. He's the world's biggest killer, that's Henry Kissinger. Right then, on April 27th, 1988, the Oregonian reported that the company had gone bankrupt and filed for bankruptcy in March 1987. This is the same week that the RBS have made another error in their accounts, and all of the capacity to give the money back to the people that were stolen from, all of the taxpayers, has disappeared again. However, company officials declared that the bankruptcy was merely a reorganisation which involved the resolving of the equity split in financial control of the company. The Van Duyne Candies reported 10 million in sales in 1986. I certainly do not suggest that any of my readers boycott their candies. That would be rather rash, and certainly is not what I want to see happen. Okay? And did you see in the lead up when I was playing the Pope's confession in the Godfather movie that the Pope helped to launch the HIV thing through a man called Wolf? Yeah? And that is the Uncle Remus, all roads lead to Rome. Yeah? The joke about America being down the Swanee because the leaders are all Freemasonic leaders with a total allegiance to the elite families that come out of America, out of Europe. Hillary. Okay, and what have we got here? We've got a blank whiteboard. Do you get that joke now? Yeah, launched by Tom Sawyer. Yeah, and launched by Mark Twain. Painting the fence white is the whiteboard joke. And it's the Bill Clinton Foundation Aryan Master Race joke. And it is Becky Thatcher and the launch of Mrs. Thatcher. She's in the Tom Sawyer story. Right? There's nothing that I do not know now. It's ever so fulfilling. And thank you to the gods for warming me up and the sun coming out occasionally now. Yeah, I'm not at risk at losing my digits now. Because of what Miss Valerie Jane Lees has done to me as the world's most informed and innocent man. Here's the pretzels. The pretzel is a cover for a prenzel, I think it was, one of the other elite families that works with the Rothschilds when they're still in Frankfurt. And they've got the black door, and the green door is just opposite them. That's for the shifts. Yeah, and all of that is interlocked with the Womble stories. Yeah, and the images of the people are those people in the Womble stories and in the BBC DJs are dead ringers for the people in my hometown. Okay, and when you look at the lineages and how all of them end up in power again, it's just the same set of families. So when he swallowed the pretzel, it's just a cover for the financial dynasties that they interlock with as the Buissons out of France. Yeah, and all of that is released by the press, like the Bin Lorry story about Bin Laden. Okay, and all in the Dragon family. This is the Murrays and the Merovingians and Hillary Clinton, and all of them are in the same bastard bloodlines. Yeah, all in the Dragon. I'm St. George, and I'm going to get it in the neck. Yeah, that's not me. That's not me getting it in the neck from them. I'm going to bring it down. Yet there never was a St. George. That's the Lydia stories and all of the Marx Brothers jokes about see no evil, hear no evil, speak no evil, and we become the world's press and the world's magicians, and all of it
is a huge belly laugh until someone comes along that can understand it and report them all for their genocides, Hillary. George W. Bush, Richard Cheney, yeah, the Cheneys of Buckinghamshire, where my wife lost the wheel of the car in front of her, the wheel came off, right on her way to work for the Duke of Bedford in all of the massive financial services frauds. Yeah, that's the Ashridge College training period, none of it declared on her CV, and I believe that she is my dragon. Yet that comes into all of the stories. Yeah, I will not kill her, I will just try to convince her to mend her ways so that our country can be competent again, and every other country that she's touched upon. Yeah, I don't know why she took the fern joke away about Holofernes and all of the jokes about the Chinooks and the Hakas in New Zealand. Yeah, she has totally dismembered that country's sovereignty, and she is a slave to the Royal Queen, that is Queen Elizabeth, the disaster zone for the whole Commonwealth, yet led into all of that by Prince Philip, who's not even got the blood to be a legitimate royal. Okay, so there's a hyperlink. We can watch something here. I'm not sure what it is. Would you like to do that as an pretzel and pressin' in the Bush and Middleton lineages? Get your tootsie fruitsie piso banknotes here. Not sure what we've got highlighted on the dragon lineage, but let's have a look. Oh, I hope that doesn't mean that we cannot get back to it. Okay, so this is the bloodline trees, where you see that the Bushes are the Debuissons, and that is the fucking Buffalo Girls joke in my favourite movie. So that, what? Take a look at it. It's watch.pair.com/dragon-lineage/3.html, and you will see that this is the Andy Murray joke, the Murray of Fala, the ancestors of FDR from Holland, and the launch of World War I by President Wilson, and the launch of World War II by President FDR, the Delaney's fucking donkey joke. And there, and this is Revelations, they want this written out of the Bible. And there was an uprising against me at Jehovah's yesterday. They've now had to create organ music, and they play it on the computers. Yeah, because of the influence of the music that drives me along. Yeah. And they've got a totally different hymnary to every other religion, and they're launching new hits on it in recent weeks, since I exposed all of them as being the Taze Russell Mafias. Yeah, with the massive links to all of those corrupted religions, and the thingy army, the Salvation Army, all of them run by the Rothschilds. Right then, so here's the bloodlines for Hillary Clinton, George W. Bush and Richard Cheney. Hillary Rodham Clinton, and some of the names on there are quite stunning. Okay, Pierre Trudeau, Jean Chrétien of Canada, direct bloodlines that link you into her ruthless family. Her name is Hillary because it is Hell Arius. Yeah, do you get it? The authors of the Bible, the most powerful genealogical bloodline of the lot. She's in the fucking thing. Yeah, and she with Bill, yeah, now run all of the acts of God are going to be a tax on breathing for the poor people. Yeah, I doubt that God will let them get away with it. Bill had his quadruple bypass operation way back after he had dropped out of office. Yeah, and all of the shagging of Monica Lewinsky is the cover for the linkages in that elite family to Hitler Rothschild and Eva Braun with the little blue dress. Yeah, with the spunk on it. Yeah, which is the joke, and all of the joke about the cigar tube is the British American tobacco joke that you now understand intimately. Okay, I'm not going to waste any more time on that. We will probably now have to use both of my hands to find. Oh no, we're lucky. So do you get it? This is the same family that are the Pi Pi Pillsbury Doughboy family, yeah, that are the and that's dough in a monetary sense. Yeah, and it's the same. She may not be in it, but her family interlock to Longshanks and the English treason and the takeover of Scotland, which is why she's able to visit Edinburgh, and the whole of treasonous Scotland welcomes their visits. They've got the royal palace right opposite Holyrood. Yeah, that's the Hollywood joke. Yeah, on the other side of the Atlantic, and the Queen still gets their taxes from America in the ancient treaties that America never gets alive because of people like Field McConnell and all of the false news experts that will not challenge the tyrannous leadership of their countries. Yeah, that's why Hawkins, his mate, is so offensive to me. He speaks in pristine English, and his daughter reads the news, yeah, and defends the world wildlife land grabs all over Africa and the killing of all of the poor people in that massive continent where only 4 people have access to electricity. Banknotes here, yeah, that's the Piso Mint in Rome, 120 BC. And that's the Marx Brothers, get your tootsie footsie, yeah, frauds here, from the Masons. And Harpo Marx speaks and hears perfectly well, but he's the optimal person for the hear no evil, see no evil, speak no evil joke. All of it, all of the great conflicts are Freemasonic jokes like that. And all of the war dead are carrying the can for the religious persecution and the launch of all of the false Piso religions right into Constantinople. Okay. So, Teviot Valley, again, Bruce and Bush intertwine. Okay, George Bush is descended from several English and Scottish monarchs who were also ancestors of John. So this is Robert Livingston of Ancrum, just up the road, up the Teviot fucking valley. Yeah, when we came back from New Zealand, there was a lethal car crash in that region, and it involved the man Hogg, who's now the Scottish rugby hero. I played rugby against his dad. All of them are totally in denial about the Hoyk lottery win and all of the cover-ups of all these massive frauds that lead to the genocide led by George W. Bush, who choked on the pretzel in Iraq with Tony Blair, the current covert leader of the Council for the Future of Europe. Unelected in all of those things, £10,000 per lecture hour, which is above the minimum wage for a year's work. Okay, Robert Livingston, immigrant from Scotland to New York. Do you get it? This is Robert the fucking Bruce, the traitor. Yeah, the man that kills the Commons. And the only thing that dampens my ardour for Miss Comyn is that she looks dead like the beautiful blonde woman who is hot lips in the jokes that Field McConnell and the Nuttings still share about the brutalisation of Vietnam. Yeah, watch the 3 Hillary C word videos and understand that the whole of the South Pacific, the whole of Indochina, and all of the Golden Triangle is for narcotics. And the Godfather, the original Godfather 1, did not want to take that on because it was immoral. Okay, and there's the bloodlines. This is the Livingstons of the River Nile. Yeah, and in the Godfather movie, they celebrate Khartoum. It's one of the families too. Even more of a string of strange coincidences. Okay, they're dead keen to get my computer shut up they're going to take me out of the Google system now, because it was led, I was led into it so they could surveil me, but now that I use it as the broadcasting engine for their frauds and their genocides, David Cameron, none of you are prepared to live with that and the sharing of information that could free the whole world, not just one country. Even more, a string of strange coincidences. One of the men who owns the two Van Din stories is an ex-missionary to Taiwan and a minister. Here's my greatest hero, the actor, that has his tongue in his cheek, like the Godfather, all of the time, Robert De Niro. Yeah? And that's Nero in the Roman court joke. Yeah? Who was murdered by the Piso family. Yeah? And he becomes the one that whistles while Rome burns. Fiddles, rather. Yeah? That's the Jewish fiddle. Because the Jews, Herod, was in the team that wrote the Christian Bible, and he's the man that makes the decision on Jesus, who never lived, future. And then when they create Constantinople, that's the launch point for every war. Yeah, and that becomes the mosque in the EastEnders comedies. Yeah, there's Pope Francis. Yeah, Gorgoglio, and that's one of those pictures will be of him giving confession to Vidal. Yeah, all of it is the same jokes. This is the cull of all of the Latin American countries. Yeah, and when you look at Google Books and the Latin American, there's a man called Cortez who was a lethal killer, and they pretend that all of the people that were the heads of the Incas and the massive dynasties that led Latin America, yeah, and fought against them, they then pretend that they jumped sides and joined the elite families. I have no way of knowing whether that is correct. Okay, and this is the mission film about Christianity, and folk like Archbishop Tartaglio are the decision makers about how many people get killed, what happens to the religion, what happens to the defoliation of the massive forests that they have there, and the brutalization of that. And then that becomes the beef industry when they flatten the forests, and we've got global warming because there's no taking up of the carbon, because all of the elite families have flattened the rainforests all over the world, and the poor have to pay the tax on it. And Clinton will build you an eco hotel to live in. That is the Britney Spears Ooh La La video, and the video that has been blocked globally ever since I published it a couple of years ago, when the Germans nearly won the Melrose Fascist Sevens. Yeah, there he is in his compassionate role as the world's leading genocidal expert, and his boss Benedict was just a cover for the Pope in World War One that led the Nazis. And so Benedict was World War One, Pius XII is World War II, with the canary on his shoulders for laundering the Nazis through the Canaries, where John Patterson is friends of the Mafias. Yeah, and that is the Cray twins that he used to work with. All of them, that's the creches that actually printed the Quran in Mecca and launched it in Mecca, but they lived in Tel Aviv. This is the fat bastard that is now dead, I believe. Yeah, he's Lord Patton of Hong Kong. Yeah, he's a massive fraudster. He's on the board of all of those Future of Russia foundations, the 600 companies that the Queen runs, and he's the boss at Lunro and Lungmin, who still shoot the blacks in the pay rounds, Mrs. Valerie Jane Lees, despite your affiliations to all of those jokes that you have about, yeah, all of those folk that you negotiated with at Otago Polytechnic, and all of the jokes about the black man being suppressed by the white master race that you represent. Yeah, and that is the Kiwi joke about Holofernes. Yeah, massive jokes about the whole nation and its ownership for ages and ages and ages, since Captain Cook sailed from Scarborough, where the massive villain that is Jimmy Savile was a freeman of the town. Okay, Free Chinese Army, this ex-missionary is still on best of terms, close friend. So do you get that? This is a missionary in Taiwan, which is an island off mainland China. Massive battles about the ownership of it for all of the time that he was stealing in Hong Kong and returned on Prince Charles's private yacht. Yeah, all the elite sailing jokes. Yeah, that's Alan Bond in Australia, who Peter Eyre worked for in the false news sector. Three Chinese army generals. He drives Cadillacs, and when he visits China, is given the red carpet. I've forgotten who that was. Let's find that out again. So that's the bloodlines of the Bouchers. One of the men who owns two Van Din stores is an ex-missionary to Taiwan and a Christian minister. Yeah, so that's why I've got the mission movie with all of the South African genocides and the Christian cross for a laugh dropping over the waterfall. The great cataracts are formed by the gods in the places where the biggest crimes happen. That's why they've got one on the Balfour's farm where I was born. Right then. So this is the communists again, funded by the Rothschilds, and here is that joke. Okay, Marx and Engels, Lenin and Stalin, all of them funded by the Rothschilds to dismember, as English speaking people, the whole of China, the Indochino region, and the whole of fucking Russia. And that's the Gazprom scam that is still going on, involving the rich list leaders that are the Timoshenko covers out of Ukraine. And she was on rehab because they put her in a straitjacket too. All of false news in on every theme all across the world, and now totally understand it. And so should you, because I speak plain English. This ex-missionary person, minister, was a friend of mine in the Van Din Dutch Mafias, and in 1990, when he heard that I'd written a book, he was excited to buy my book because we were friends. So there's a picture, because they do not provide any illustrations of what's happened to these places since all the scams were initiated, of China. And offshore, you've got Hong Kong. So you've got Hong Kong right in the corner. I visited that when my plane got diverted there by God. And there is Taiwan offshore. Yeah? In other people's hands. Or the whole of China is being taken over by Wouters Cloyters. And that's Nancy McKinstry. And it's the Trans-Pacific Trade Delegation that created the tsunami in Japan the day they visited there, and it created the tsunami, the earthquake in Christchurch, the fudge about Christianity in the centre of that massive city, yeah, that got a huge earthquake, and all of the rugby pitches that are the Holofernes jokes, yet they could not use them because of the massive instability of those massive fraudulent structures. And that's you, John Key, the hedge fund manager. Yeah, when he found out that the title was the Watchtower, this is the writings that this guy's engaged in, and the Masons, he immediately lost interest in the book. That's why, yeah, that's the whole of Jehovah's Witnesses, the newest religion on the world. Yeah, all of it has rewritten all of the stories again, and Jesus is all through it, and Jesus never fucking lived. Macau is right next door to Treblinka. And that's Henry Macau, is the Macau that is part of the crime scene that is the taking over by England of all of China. Yeah, Lord Patton was the Governor General there for years and years and years. Yeah, and we started yesterday on Tiananmen Square, and that is Kate Adey and all of the English frauds all around the world. Okay, and all of the false religions, all funded by the 13 Illuminati families. And Henry Macau is a child genius, and Macau is right next door to Treblinka.
Not many people know that until I come along.
And even Field McConnell, the traitor, is quite happy to say that, no, we've never heard any of those things before, George, and we'd love to have you back every fortnight until President Obama makes him change his mind. I asked him if he knew anything about the Freemasons, and he said he knew absolutely nothing about them. Yeah, that's the Freemasons that are running all the false religions, with Taze Russell and the Russell group that now steal from the British students. And he's a leader of the Kiwanis, this one. How did this minister arrange for his Kiwanis? Do you get it? The Kiwis? Yeah, all of the jokes I've just told you that launch the Hollow Fernies joke about the fern on the Kiwis rugby jersey, and that's the Jewish woman that beheaded Hollow Fernies in the Bible that was written by the Pisos. Yeah, how did this minister arrange for his Kiwanese club to meet in a Masonic lodge, yet know nothing about the Masons? Okay, another branch of the Mafias. Joseph C. Prince and Alan B. Brown. Okay, and further, there are many Masons with this surname. I'm not sure what the surname is. The type is too small on that to see. So they're launched out of Indianapolis, the Indy 500. Yeah, and that's the racetrack jokes. Detroit, Michigan. They've got massive revenues, 20 billion. Community service. Further, there are many Masons with this surname. So that, at least within this his extended family, I would expect community service. Do you get it? That at least within his, I would expect some of them are Masons. Later, this man's son-in-law, also a minister, called me to this son-in-law's office in a particular church and told me I should be excommunicated by Christians for trying to expose Billy Graham, means the devil. Yet in the beautiful film about the blonde and the otter in Scotland, her lover is Graham. Yet means the devil. Even though this minister's church doesn't excommunicate, he gave me mean looks and further told me, you will die for your sins. I don't know if this owner of Van Dyne Stores has any relationship to the larger picture. However, all of this is just a number of strange coincidences. Let's show you Billy Graham. He's really sinister. Van Dyne and the CIA, MI6, Mossad, NSA, etc. MI6 was intimately involved in the creation of the CIA and Mossad. It's the Jewish religion, which every woman married to every Gentile across the world is obligated to report to Miss Valerie Jane Lees if you're married into the Gentile community. And MI6 is the guiding hand behind those two organisations. British Intel was integrated under the title British Security Coordination, which was the world's largest and most powerful intelligence beast in the world. This beast has been under total control by the Illuminati since its beginning. So that's World War II, when the Flemings were almost entirely in charge of all of it, and Mossad had not yet been created. As a huge menace, Jim Murphy, the Friends of Israel in every capitalist organisation across our world, that's Jim Murphy in East Renfrewshire, who just happened to be passing by when the profiteers blew up the Clutha pub. Yeah, as a total false news diversion from everything that the Scottish government has done. Yeah, and he is in the English government, Jim Murphy is, as a treasonous Scotsman. Since 1940, when the BRSC was set up in New York, the Americans have worked for the British. Yeah, Field McConnell understands that as a traitor, but the and that's why he's Hawkins' mate. Yet, like the Hawkins boss at the Jehovah's, yet are getting ever so nervous about what God will do to them when they're forced to meet their maker. But the intelligence community in the UK, USA, Canada, Australia, NZ, yeah, I'd never heard of any of these organisations, have now got them pinned. Yeah, that's the Piso pin word. Yeah, and that is the joke.
about the Christian cross. Can you guess what the pins are and why I have a box of nails in my portfolio of exhibits about world history and about how you save your fucking soul if you're a profiteer in religion? Okay, so all of the intel had been set up all around that Commonwealth so that the Queen can keep the whole world under her high heels. Yet that's her fascist heel. They have actually signed formal agreements which completely make all of these acronym monsters into one intelligence agency working for Her Majesty, who tried to kill me using my wife as the intel presence in my innocent family, using the NHS doctors that they have trained in this fascist way, since all of those doctors were killed in Argentina by the employer of the now Dutch Queen's dad, who ran the junta and killed the poor in those massive stadia crimes in the 1960s when Valdivia had the biggest earthquake, Valerie Jane Lees. There is the technical cooperation. God, I'm getting loads of stuff out in this one. And you can confess if you're part of the fraud. The Brusa Arrangement Agreement on May 17th, 1943 established exchange of personnel, intimate cooperation at the highest levels by the various national... That's in mid-war, by the way. Do you understand that, Tom Hanks, on the beachhead at Normandy with all of those people with the blood hanging out? And you're a Rockefeller, aren't you? Various national intelligence agencies of all high grade comment a secret treaty of 1947. Yeah? BBC Light Entertainment was the next employer of Klaus Maswich. Yeah? That's all of those jokes about Superman and all of the cartoon characters and all of the Zionist leadership teams, both sides of the Atlantic, and now with Mossad and the CIA running the show. Linked to all the major Commonwealth and American intel groups, this is just one of countless agreements, most secret for the exchange of information. That's the way our world is run, and the bin lorry gets put in the papers on the front page every day in Scotland, with the Wombles and Jimmy Savile beyond the grave. Isn't that really civilised, Hannah Rothschild? Yeah, with a sense of humour and admiring all of the criminals for their capacity to laugh at the killing of all of the world's citizens through every one of those periods. Yeah, and right beyond that, we become Peace Prize winners. At that time, levels of secrecy were ultra, very secret, peril, moderately secret, and thumb secret. Do you understand now the launch of Pearl Harbor and the implications of that for Japan, the innocent nation where their people are so obedient that they have to fall on their swords for the emperor who dies in his bed, or right almost into the noughties? Okay, Pearl and Thumb later become Pi Pi Pinups. On 17th February 1972, a National Security Council Intelligence Director, NSID, directed the NSA to be the principal US SIGINT. That's a joke about the SIGINT in the Bible. Yet the Piso Pi Pi Pinup Bible. Yeah? SIGINT. SIGINT agency with the FBI and CIA basically working for the NSA. Although some people are claiming that there is friction between the NSA and front organizations, the FBI and the CIA. That's the CIA that runs Facebook. Yeah, do you get the FBI that runs Facebook joke now? It is hard to picture that this friction is anything serious because many people in these front organisations work for the NSA. Next image is British family de Buisson Normandy Buffalo Girls joke.
This is the bushes again, and that in the Bible is the burning bush joke. Right then, so there's George W. and Herbert Poppy, and that's the Poppea joke, and I've told you that again and again and again, and I've shown you it in images. That's him. He's a massive genocidal bastard. Yeah, and he is the launch of all of those scams that killed Saddam, if Saddam was ever killed. Okay, the CIA, MI6 and the Mossad all worked through the BCCI, which was scandalised recently, although the elite kept the lid on the scandal. Not sure what the BCCI is. Hillary Clinton, Bill Oreo Hallett, Little Blue Dresses, HRH, yeah, all of it is the same frauds, and all of the media releases get them deeper and deeper into trouble since I came along, Hillary Clinton, yeah, and Donald Trump, and all the Tusk jokes are now over. That's since I talked about the Oliphants and all the treason in the Central Belt at Scotland since the Braveheart film was made there. That's the killings at Falkirk, that's the Torah Wood, and that's the Torah that is the Jewish religion for a joke. Hillary Clinton, Bill Gregg Hallett, Little Blue Dresses, okay? All of the illegitimacy of the royals, all of the work of Hallett that I've profiled in great detail, all of the River Spree crimes of the Saunderses, yeah, who I meet all the time, they're really nice people, and all they need to do is to drop the ancient linkages to fascism, and we could have a country again. Yeah, there's the little blue dress on the, with this Bill Clinton spunk on it. That's Monica Lewinsky's joke about Eva Braun in the bunker in Berlin. And there's all the EU politicians and all the fraudsters and the hole in the Maginot Line at Brie, right next to Waterloo. And all of the jokes are about financial services and the ownership of all of the central banks that could be the people's if any of you were to wake up from your massive coma that you get from watching the sport on their fucking telly all the time, where every sportsman is launched into the team to cover the political news that week. Thank you to the innocent locals in Kelso's Fishing Club for trying to grasp what has happened to our beautiful region that could be owned entirely by you and your families for the rest of your life if you were to wake up and to expose the frauds with me in unison. Unison is led by the Bank of England man now, the British Union leader that is David Prentice. It's all a joke at your expense, and the wars are the biggest belly laughs for all of these people. And Clinton is Her Majesty the Queen's half-brother. And here's the frauds in the modern day dynasty, okay? That's Commoner Kate, together the UK, and that is a royal wedding, and this is their song about their allegiance to Great Jehovah. What they've done, if there is a Great Jehovah, and nobody's allowed to know their names, but the Jehovahs proclaim, because Russell is in the mafias, that Jehovah is the only name to use. Yeah, and that's the Monty Python's jokes, and all of the jokes about virgins. Yeah, this is a prostitute marrying, yeah, the illegitimate child of Queen Elizabeth II, who was sired by King Juan Carlos of Spain. Yeah, he killed his brother when he was a boy so that he could become the king, because his brother was the legitimate claimant, and that's the El Cid jokes. Okay, together the UK and USA intelligence community, or what is better termed the New World Order's Intel, Worldwide Intelligence Agency, of which MI5, MI6, CIA, NSI, FBI, NZ, SIS, yeah, never heard of it before, I've now got page after page of profiles on